Hello, this is Dimitri with UGears US, and we're doing another video. This one is on UGears Mechanical Flower, one of my favorite models. It looks very nice, decorative piece, very detailed, and I love showing it to customers like during the shows and at the retail show. So we're gonna go ahead and start with this. So just as always, gotta remove the plastic from the box. First step, put it aside. Easy to open. Shouldn't be too long. I think the first one took me about an hour to put together, so I'm expecting about the same from this one. So nice three plates. Lots of plastic, as always, just to make sure that the boards stay nice and dry, regardless of the condition during the shipping. Here you go, got some toothpicks, gonna put it aside right away, so it's not on the way. Have the my manual. And as always, we're gonna go through the first initial steps that make sure you are very careful. Well, don't light the candle on fire. We have the candle here. It's a tea candle. You can use any candle as a wax. I just happen to have a lot of tea candles in my house. So that's the one that I'm using. I have almost unlimited access to it. And obviously when you press the toothpicks, don't press it on the sharp end because you will hurt yourself. So as far as the warnings and the instructions, if you see this sign right here with a candle and a gear and a toothpick, that means put some wax on a specific surface that is shown on there. Use the sandpaper instead of the sandpaper. For me, I prefer to use the files. Little precision files I have available. You don't need to get the file, so either a sandpaper file or nail file will work. So those are some of the tools that you can use. The next one is to use the knife. Show them the X-Acto knife. Use the box cutter. Mine is also being used and abused. It still works, so good for me. If you see exclamation points, you gotta pay attention to that specific step. If you don't, you will mess it up. Or have a very high chance of messing it up. If you see add, that means it's additional parts that we have access to, and the X-Acto knife onto the board, that means you need to cut out the part because it is pretty fragile or delicate. And then if you see this where it says you gotta press on the parts in order to get it to work or get something inserted. And then obviously, we do have a helper tool. Well, not obviously, but like with a lot of models, we do have a helper tool, and that's the first one that I'm gonna take out besides the ones that are falling out. And then just have it here on the side. So let's go ahead and, I do have another tool, which is the little cutters here. I do use them as pliers if I need to pull the toothpick out. Just grab lightly on it and pull it out, or chop it off or cut it in half if I need to. So let's go ahead and start with the assembly. We have the helper tool. We do have the need to start with wheel number one. It's right here that I had available. That's a board that was on the bottom. So one of the suggestions is to push the boards from back to front, back being a little bit darker face, front is the face that is more cleaner. Should say that's where the laser comes out and looks a little bit nicer. So when you push it from the back to the front, you're actually pushing the fibers and they're not gonna pull off the part, they're gonna pull off the board face. So let's do that. So the first one, and we need three toothpicks for that. It's shown in step number two. So we get the three toothpicks, and remember the tool I was telling you about. Here it comes in handy right away. might not always be the choice or good choice, because when you do squeeze it, instead of the round end, it's kind of like a flat end. So, but so either part, either side can be a front face, and you just insert the toothpicks in the 6 holes that are here. So you can start them up, and then as far as they can go with your fingers, and then use your table as the helping tool. I guess starts out pretty good for me. Actually, I can push them pretty nice. And then if that doesn't help, I just lightly press, making sure I'm not gonna break the toothpick. Press it in. Also, another one, you can use your helper tool and kind of move it from one side. Careful with that, also balancing it out, because you're at risking snapping out toothpick at the base. So as you press that, you gotta do the little bit balancing. Not too hard. I mean, even if you snap it like I just did, depending on location and what the next step is, it might not be a problem at all. So in this case, it's not, because we do need to cut to that. So we put like on the step 3, it shows that we need to use that helper tool, put it on here, and actually cut it to the face of that tool. So I use my cutter tool. That's one of the options. Or the other options, if you don't have that available, you use your knife and you just start it off at the base, and then you can kind of clean it up, not clean it up, but snap it. So if you start it with your knife and then you snap it off, and you're good to go. So that's one of the steps. We're in the step number 5 already. It does show like that you do need to use a toothpaper or file, or toothpaper, sorry, the sandpaper or file, in order to clean off the toothpick. So it's flat to that helping tool. So, and that's because there's gonna be some part rubbing to it. So this is the short one that I had in there, so which is, once again, it's fine. I'm gonna use my cutters, it just makes it a little bit easier. I have toothpicks flying around, which is, doesn't make it easier. So I snap all 6 of them. And then I'm gonna go through my with my file. Clean it off. Make sure it's not sharp. Make sure it's right up to the edge. It's not sticking out. And I think I got all 6 now. Now, one of the steps that I missed is the we do need to put a little bit of wax on here, so I'll use one of the toothpicks, kind of get some wax out from the candle, get a, like a bigger piece. And then the other thing with the wax, then when you wax it on, as you hold it with your finger, you kind of start feeling that it melts. So the wax is needed to give it a little bit of lubrication, because we do have wood on wood. And when you have that situation, there's a lot of friction. So we need to make sure that we remove that friction as much as possible. Hence the use of the lubricant, or in this case it's candle wax, because it doesn't melt as much and it doesn't get absorbed into the wood as much. Gives it a nice smooth surface, nice and clean. All right, So we're that. Just give me a second. I want to make sure that
we're still operational and the video is running, so we're good to go.
All right, and let's see. So we're done with step number, or page number 4, and we're moving on to the next sheet. Here we have, starting off with the gears, first we do need some toothpicks, and also 3 toothpicks, so total, you'll get total of 6 halves. Same as the other one, because we are using, actually, you know what, I'm gonna use the ones that we just cut off, because they're long enough in order to be reused, well, the ones at least that are left. So I got 4, and all I need is another half of the toothpick in order to, because I used it. Actually, I can use this up too, from the wax, the ones that I use for the wax. And before I use it, we need the part number 7, which is 6 gears. So I'm gonna push the whole block out. And then from back to front, push the gears out. And then we do need to make sure that there is no fibers in between the gears. So for that, the connection points, I'll clean off with my little file. And that's the reason why I use the file, is because it's easier to get into the between the teeth. Any other tool, it's a little bit harder, although the toothpaper you can kind of fold in half and then get it in between the teeth. So the reason why you need to clean it off is because the gear engagement, and if there is something stuck in between, that will prevent it from moving, or make it hard, at least in the beginning, until that little fiber piece breaks off or something, and then and then it starts working smoother. All right. Got a few more to go. Just as I said, I just want to make sure the fibers are cut off. And then we need to wax these gears. With the candle wax. Toothpick to get a bigger piece out. Here we go. That one's going to be easier to hold, and it can. So we need it on the surface of the gear. One of the surfaces. So. And then also on the gears themselves. And then the way I put it on the gears is just dip them into the candle, considering this is the tea candle, and they're fairly inexpensive. I think you get like hundreds of them for like $4. At least IKEA has them, I think, for that price. If not, even Walmart and such would have them. So the next step is we're moving over to step number 3, and that's where we're just inserting the toothpick into the whole side hole, not the center one, and pushing it all the way through. We do need to do it on 6 parts, as said on following step number 4 and 5, after 4, step number 5. You have generous amount of lubricant, make sure, well, I think both surfaces will need to be waxed eventually. I don't need very much of a length on that toothpick. It just same thing. I just use the tool to cut it to a specific size. And then we also, looks like I do need to wear safety glasses as they're flying left and right. And make sure, cut it off so the top surface is nice and smooth. Let me try to see what it is going to be with the knife. So I guess it doesn't matter much which step I use. So I'll just put it on the side. I'll use my cutters and just makes it quicker. And cleaner. Make sure you cut it as close to the surface as possible so you have nice flush toothpick. Another one flew out. So I guess I'll have to be on my floor afterwards picking those up. Eventually I'll get the technique and that will help me to do that. But as far as the flower, this is a pretty repetitive piece because you have six sides to it. And it's pretty much the same thing for every side. So it's a lot of repetitive motion. But at the end you get a very beautiful product. Alright, so we got six of this. And then the next step, our part number six connected with part number five. So I'm just trying to push the whole block out. I don't know if it's gonna work. And then for number fives. So there's six of these. One, two, three. The cracking you hear once again is breaking the, board, not the actual parts. And I can put that aside. Clean off all the fibers, and then part number five. These are little teeth, smaller parts, a little bit harder to push out, but just work it back and forth. And then they will eventually fall out from the board. The other suggestion is not to rush through the assembly, because when you start rushing, you start breaking pieces or not putting them correctly. It does happen to me sometimes as I'm trying. Limitation on time, and I'm trying to get through the video. Make sure that I go through the whole assembly in a fairly short amount of time, so you guys are not bored and not watching a 15-hour video of me assembling like a locomotive or a fire truck or any of the other parts that are take a long time to put together. So I think I just did a locomotive video, which ended up being about a little over 5 hours. It's still a lot, but it's much better than 10 hours that what it normally would take to assemble it if you go everything very slow and nice motion. So we need to make sure that the, well, we don't have any other choice to put it any other way. So you have one boss and then two little bosses there stand out, and you gotta just insert it and make sure that it's inserted all the way in and it's flush. There's no hole in between the parts. So we got six components like that. You had them push them through, push them in. And as you see, I just turn it upside down and push it against the table to start them up. And then we can do that with these pieces because they're pretty strong. And as I said, as long as you get it in at least halfway, it should be good. I'm not going to be able, or not going to be breaking them. All right, and then we also dip it into wax. Six. All right, now we move over to next page, number six. And here's the assembly of the wheel. So we do need part number three, which is that outside loop right here. And then we do need gear number 8 on the same board. So let's push this one out first. So the outer portion, I'd say, should go from back to front. The inner portion, on the other hand, should go from front to back, because once again, depending which way you push it, so as you see, there's fibers are stuck on here, so I pulled the fiber off the board. And you don't want to pull the fiber off the actual piece, so the inner piece you push the other way, so that way the fiber will stay on the on your board and you're going to be pushing it from this one. So we got that, and then we'll need this piece eventually, but not at this time. So I'm going to put it aside. We do need number 8, so this is a little delicate piece, so careful pushing that one out. Make sure there's no fiber in between the gears. Clean it off, and then we'll start the main assembly. So we have this one prepared. We put the all six gears on it, and then with the, looks like on step number 2, we gotta line up these little toothpicks that are sticking out, and there's a line kind of like two little dashes. So we gotta line it towards the center. Let's say there's also there are lines on the middle piece number 8. So you gotta line up those with piece number 8. So toothpick goes towards the center, which lines up with the line. Lines up with the gear on the inside. Get all of those in first, and I'll take the 8 out so it's not really on the way. All right, so I need to make sure that all the toothpicks are facing inward. Then I put the number 8 lining up the lines on the gears with the, I gotta clean it off. See a little fiber on here. I don't want it to be an interference in the operation. Here's a little bit more, so kind of look, glance through the gear, make sure you don't have those fibers on there that are sticking out too much. So your lines on that number 8 should line up with the little dashes on the smaller gears, and it will line up with the little toothpicks that are sticking out on those gears. So line up here, line up there. So it's all lined up, line through, and then we put the outside gear on with the U gears facing up. There's also little dashes on there, so you match those dashes with the gears just like that. So the next step is to insert these little guys. The toothpicks go into the slot right here, toothpicks on the gears, and then you insert them to face the in. Kind of like this, except should be more like a little flower. Alright, and we're good with that portion. We're already on step number two, finishing up, page number six. Moving over to, so we're gonna put this one aside, careful, because that big gear is not, so you gotta kind of grab it from the bottom, put it on the side, and then we move to page number seven. And that's, we'll go on to the second board. First time we're done except this piece, but we don't need it right now. So we started with this one. We will need this little inner piece, and then all six of these leaves, or branches, I should say. So we actually go from the back towards the front. Look for the connection points, and that's where you want to press. In order not to break the part. So another recommendation would be to use the X-Acto knife to cut those connection points. That way you're not going to damage the part for sure. So I got that middle piece out. And actually I do need number nines first. That's my step number one. I do need for the assembly. So we need two for each branch. Got those two out. And then you insert them with the hook facing towards inside. And that doesn't matter from which side. So kind of slide them in on one side. And before we do that, we gotta wax it on the side that's gonna be facing in. So a little bit of wax in. And the second piece, same thing, hook on towards the inside. So your inner piece or your inner face would be waxed. Just like that. And then you insert it into the slot on the opposite end. That, and then we use one of the number 10s and with the teeth facing down we wax both sides right here for smoother operation. And we kind of slide it in between these two number nine pieces that we just put in. So as we slide through, we need a toothpick, half of it. So pre-cut it with a knife, one of the ways, and then snap it in half, or use the cutters if you have them to cut it in. And then just insert the toothpick through that assembly until it's flush. Go to the next page, which is number eight, which says for us to break it from the other end. So quick at it and snap it off. One of the simpler ways. And then that's, we're done with first one. Kind of push it back. And then do it 6 more times. So I'll prepare all these number 9 pieces. I'll be quiet until I complete that task. Once again, it's a repetition, it's the same thing for all 6 branches. So we got these out, and then we need the number 10s. Fairly delicate. One. Two. Six were already put on. So the main thing, we need to wax these 2 sides and all of them, and then the inner faces of those little parts, number 9. It's just up to you which one's going to become the inner face. So I'd say, as you put them in, wax them as you put them in. Toothpick, slide it through. Use helper tool to push it through if it's not going very well. And then cut it off. Pre-cut and snap. So make sure it moves with a little. This does have a little friction. That's what the wax is for. It's kinda, it would have been more friction if we haven't removed it, or if we haven't put the wax on it. Just gonna get a little bigger piece. And kinda work my way around. Another toothpick. pre-cut. Cut in half and push it through. Helper tool. Cut it off. Push it back, make sure it works. Good. Next step. Find the right angle to pre-cut that piece. And we got two more to go. One more to go. That's it. Well, probably I have enough thickness on there, so that one's good to go. Alright, so make sure all of those pieces work. May not be very smooth out right now, but eventually, as you work it more and more, it'll get smoother and smoother. Alright, so we got this piece completed, and we're moving on to the page number 9. And here we do need to pull that middle piece out, piece number 12. Once again, apply a little pressure where the connection points are at, and you can pull it out with ease. Turn that whole piece upside down, and then put it on top. So it kind of slides in, doesn't like snap in, but it should stay in place. Without much effort or get in place. And now, let's see, we do need to wax in between. So because there's going to be these little guys, oops. My ring back on. Wanted to show you guys what I meant, but this little teeth will go in between, so we want to put a little bit of wax which is gonna be kind of tough. So I with a toothpick and I can try to apply it on the sides. In six places. I'm pretty much getting some wax on the inside, and then we'll hope that it'll spread out once it gets in contact with the other pieces. Wax in there, and now we need parts number two, all six of them. Once again, I'm breaking the board, not the parts. Put the board aside, and then we insert it with that little bigger hook from the bottom into the little arrow pieces to lock these in place and kind of kick it back. So that smaller hook is facing towards the inside. Six sides, so kind of locking the two, this little two flowers together. All right, and we're done with page number nine. Now, the warning. During the assembly, all the petals should be in open flower position. If necessary, adjust internal parts as shown in the picture. So this is the most important step. All the have to be in the open position. Not closed, not like this, but like this, all the way to the back. And that's the way you insert it into the assembly. And then I'll move that closer to me. I'll kind of like make sure all these little keys are facing the same direction. And then I insert. There's little holes on there, so the ones, the parts that we just inserted, they should go through these holes. So I'm starting them to push into the holes, just to make sure that we get them seated. And then you use the helping tool in order to adjust this little keys right underneath the leaves, the petals, right? So you wanna make sure that they're engaged. So you kinda like move them to the side. that removing the big gear, obviously. Come back in place. And as you press it in, sure it lines up. So you start with one, work on the second one, keeping like the whole assembly. So your teeth and that keys, they should line up with that slot for the pedal. And it's, as it lines up, just press it down a little bit so. Go to the next side and push the other ones in. There you go. So now just need to push it. Sure they're lining up still. If not, adjust it with a helping tool and kind of press it down. So it sits completely. All the way around. Go, and that's it. So, and then let's see, I'm not sure if we can check it yet, but we'll go to the next page. I don't know if I should try or not, but we have nothing to grab on, so I can't really check it if it works or not. So just make sure that everything is seated all the way down, there is no gaps, and then we move on, kind of press it down firmly. And then we move on to the parts number 13. We need six of them, and there's one extra additional. So it is shown on the in the manual, in the instruction booklet, just in case if you break that piece, there's one extra. So, and just in case if you break that extra one, you can write me, send me a picture of the broken piece and location on the board with the my distributor sticker on the back of the unit, and that I will send you the replacement. So now we need to insert these guys. So there is a hole and then a slot that's sticking out here. So those are the two places we need to lock it with. So as you see on that piece number 13, there is a boss and then there's like a little slot. So you kind of like insert it underneath and slide it in there. That show that wax, to put a little bit of wax if you have hard time to do that. But if it slides in easy, you're good to go. You don't need that waxing portion on there. So as you can see, for me, they all slide in fairly easy. Just kind of like put it underneath and slide it into the opening to lock it in place. So, and then we need to do it through all the sides. That's pretty much the instructions on page number 11. Then we go all the way through, and I got all of the six of them are in, and they went in pretty easy. So I can set it down now and move on to page number 12. On here, we used that piece from first board. It was right in the middle. And then, remember from the back towards the front. And then we turned the unit upside down. And we sit on these little legs, which is that base. Make sure they all line up and just push them in. Should not be a big problem going in. Push it in, make sure it's fully seated. Kind of careful, make sure you're not breaking anything from the other side. And that's it. The base is ready. Now we can grab by the base and check if it rotates. So you gotta work it back and forth a little bit. Help it out. Once again, it's plywood you're dealing with, so sometimes more force is required to do certain things. So as you see, it worked a little bit. I see it starting to move, getting stuck at some location. So I'm holding by the base, which I put it on there. A little bit. Don't push it too hard. You don't want to break them. So I have already like 1/8 of a turn movement in there. And you just work it back and forth. Kind of work it in a little bit. Skipped one right now. With every time, it should be a little bit more movement. I think I skipped and then one more. Adjust it a little bit later. Not getting any further with this. something gets stuck. So I'll remove the base and I'll check what is going on. All right, and I think I see what's happening there. So the toothpicks, the ones that are from the bottom, they're sticking out right now. And they're the ones that are preventing for me to go any further. So I'm gonna kind of push the toothpicks on the little gears that are on the inside, flatten them out. And that looks like that's the issue that I'm having. So let me get these back in. So that's where the step that we need to make sure that it's flush. We need to make sure that it's flush from both ends. So let me get the base back on. Didn't have to really take it down, but those are the ones that are jumped out. Need to put them back in place. There's three of them that are popped. Kind of, they skipped a bit. Once again, need to remove the base in order to do that. Down. Make sure all the sides are back. So I set all the leaves back in place where they're supposed to be. Put my legs back in. And then the base. These guys together. So those were the toothpicks that were stuck. Now it's going a little bit smoother, at least in one direction. And then as you do it more and more often, or it's gonna get easier and easier. Now as you can see, that motion becomes much easier. And now I can go the other other direction. So everything is getting adjusted, sit it down, and now we can almost freely rotate all the pieces back and forth. So now it looks like a claw. And then the more you do it, then the easier it becomes, and eventually it's gonna be like almost like butter. So here we go. We have the motion, we have the movement. Now we can move to page number 13. And that's where the fun part begins, where you're putting the leaves on. So we got on each, we have 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, and 14. In that sequence would be the better one. We do have one additional set just in case if you guys break it. But this is the part where you need to be patient and do it very slowly, because that's when the pieces can break. So just remove it by one by one. If it is a little bit tough, once again, look for the connection points. And then if it's tough to remove it, that piece, don't try not to force it out, but use your X-Acto knife or regular knife in order to get it out, because you're risking of breaking it. And then you just insert it slowly on the slots, in the slots of the bridge. So these little leaves petals, one by one. Press it in the middle and then push it back in the center onto the branch. So if the part is not coming out, there's probably a connection point somewhere. Just use your knife. Find that connection point and kind of like easily snap it off, and that part should come out fairly easy. So we're just the way you see them, that's the way they should go into place. Once again, the most important point here is that you do need a little bit of patience, because these are fragile components, very delicate. And then if you don't have any patience, you will break it. So we have a total of 6 leaves. And I'm just gonna do, rather than one at a time, well, I'm gonna do same parts. Like, so I'll start with number 19, I'll do all 19s. I don't know, make it more fun rather than doing it one by one leaf by one leaf. Going fairly easy. Now we go with number 18. Once again, look where those connection points are at and kind of like snap them off, and the parts will fall out. probably in this case the X-Acto knife would be better than my box cutter, because the knife itself is a little thinner, the blade thinner. Six ones already on. So, and same way. Obviously, you can probably play around and put them like in different ways and see how it's gonna come out. I'm just going by the instructions, so just make it exactly as it is on the pictures. There, yep. It's a small one on the leaf. Some of it restricts, some of it doesn't. So you can give it a little cut. You can work it a little bit back and forth. That's another way to get it out. And if it doesn't, then you use your knife. So in this particular case, I have assembled the model before, so I know what I'm doing. And I guess when I'm talking about parts being fragile, I learned it the hard way. So good thing there is extras. So in case if you all of a sudden get in a rush or accidentally break a piece, you do have some extras to work with and may not need to wait for that replacement part. Three more petals, and then I apologize for that. Our baby's crying, if you guys can hear it. So it is late night. It happens. So I'll give her a flower in the morning. As you can see, as soon as I break that connection, it pretty much comes out. So done. With this leaf, and go on to the next one. Number 15. So as you can see, I mean, it's not hard model. The only reason why it's time consuming is because of the repetition and multiple pieces. But it does give a very nice, detailed, delicate, gorgeous, beautiful flower that you can give it to your loved one. You can store jewelry if you're the loved one, and do all kinds of things with it. Nice decoration piece in a living room. My vase just fell out, so I'll put the vase back in before I go further, so to make sure that it doesn't fall apart. Trying to make sure that the parts are sitting all the way in, just to make sure they don't fall out. Maybe not. Just checking if I put it in the correct way. And then we got one more piece left. I mean, one more leaf. And final portion of the assembly. Which is gonna be on page 14, my assumption. Now I really don't know. Guess we'll see. One last piece on all the petals. One. Two. Then I'm gonna clean up because there's some of the wax that I see coming out. So I want it to look nice and pretty. I don't want that wax to be all over the place. So I'm cleaning up the unit. Check it one more more time. And what's going on with my base? There you go. Open and close, it's beautiful. Now to page number 14. Now there's two options. So the first option is to have a ballerina in, and then the second option, there's like a little holder that you can have in. So I'll show both of the options. So I take the holder out, it's part number 21 and 22, kind of crisscross connection to it, set it nice and tight, open up the flower, not too much, and then you can insert it right in the middle. Right there. So I didn't push it all the way in, so I want to put a ballerina in there. But this one, you can see that it also rotates, kind of like spins around, and you can put your jewelry in there, rings, whatnot. So it gives you a little bit more room than ballerina does. So that's one option. Take it out. And the second option is ballerina. That one is a delicate piece. So I would find those connection points and then work them. Just to make sure you don't break her. Just push that out and put her down. Make sure it's nice, she sits nice and tight. And so we have a dancing ballerina inside the flower. So this piece, just extra, you can replace it or not. And then that's the flower. We're on the last page, number 15. And we're done with the assembly. So this is a nice little flower piece. Beautiful, gorgeous in any way. Now put it on your stand, furniture, anywhere you want it. Nice rotation to it. I know we usually, there is no glue for the assemblies, not needed most of the time. But like in this case, as I've been working with the base a little bit too much, it's very easy for me to take it down. So I would probably use like a drop or two of glue just to make sure it sits and doesn't fall off on me when it doesn't need to fall off. So that's it. And the assembly is completed. Everything else is nice and perfect. And might be actually the base might be falling out because of the material might be a little bit too dry. If there are any questions, any comments, just either leave them down below the video or email me at info@ugears.us. You can also contact us through the contact us form on our website. Our website is www.ugears.us. We do have this model available among other models. Everything is in stock. We do have a couple new pre-orders at this time. So if you watching it as a new video just came out, then you're gonna see those pre-orders. If not, then that means nothing is coming out at this time. Well, in either case, just please visit my website, buy from me. I'll help you with the full assembly process. And once again, if you're stuck somewhere, give me a call, send me an email. I'll help you out as much as I can. It was great doing another video for you. I will do another one soon. So as I said, I'm gonna try to cover all these models as soon as I can. And I'll see you guys later. Have a good day. UGears.us.